Hi, this is Patrick Kalange, and I'm going to be showing you a few things in FontLab today. I'm just going to be making an alternate ampersand, and I'm going to show you the process here in FontLab. Let's get started. So first of all, I'm going to start with the ampersand that I already have. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut pieces of this apart because I want to add a few other things to it to make a different style. So I'm going to cut this off here. Actually, we'll cut it off here where it connects. And here, I'll delete this piece. You can see that now there's a piece missing here. So I'm going to steal a part of the E here. And you know, that's pretty close to what I'm kind of going for, but this part here needs to come out a little bit more. It's going to come up from here and go out and maybe end here instead of inside. I'm going to fix up all these curves in just a second. And we're actually going to have to make it end right here. So we'll just cut that piece off for now. Move it off to the right here. Out of the way. Yeah, so this is roughly the ampersand I was looking for. So let's go ahead and make some changes here. Yeah, something like this, except for obviously we're going to have to change these curves and make them better. I like to keep things in this is called the metrics window right here. So you can actually type a word in here while you're working on the letter. So you can actually see how the letters look next to each other while you're crafting them. And that's important because you want them to balance with each other. You want them to, you know, balance in weight and width, things like that. So I keep them in my metrics window here. All right, so smooth this curve out slightly, but we'll still work on this part here. I know I want it to come up and fill this negative space in here. So I think it's in the right spot. I just need to move it up a little bit. See, I'm constantly looking over here in the metrics window to make sure it's balancing out with itself. Okay. Now I'm actually going to make the end piece here. Have it. Alternate ampersand. So we took this one that I had already made, we cut it up and added a few pieces and made this alternate ampersand. Looks pretty good. Just gonna weld these two pieces together like that. Leave these separate in case I need to adjust them later if I come back. It's kind of how I work a little bit. You'll work on it a little bit, you'll leave, and then you'll come back and you'll notice something that's off. A lot of the times when you're working, you can't notice that. And it takes leaving and coming back to actually realize your mistakes. That's actually a pretty good way to work, really.